Hi.
In a lobby.
I'm here with Jon Campbell from the Microsoft Enable team. And Jon, today we're going to talk about eye control and what's coming next. You want to tell us a little bit about it?
So people living with ALS, they lose their ability to move, but they can still use their eyes. So Steve Gleason contacted Microsoft and was asking us how can he use his Surface device with an eye tracker and software and hardware in order to use it better, to communicate more naturally with his wife,
right,
and to be able to move his wheelchair independently.
That's right.
Since that time, the work has evolved. And so in cooperation with the Windows team, we created Eye Control for Windows to allow people to use an eye tracking interface to control their Windows device.
Yeah, no, that's just amazing. I mean, what it has done for anyone with ALS to be able to, in fact, communicate,
right,
using eye control has been fantastic to see. And so now you're enhancing it in some way?
Absolutely, yeah. So at Build this year, we announced our Eye Control APIs, which allow any developer to harness the power of eye control for their own applications to add accessibility for eye tracking.
Very cool. So they can start building apps that enhance or just incorporate eye control in the app.
Yes. And so one example of that is iDrive. So it's an open source initiative that we created to allow you to do basically a virtual joystick with your eyes. So you can control things like an RC car or even a wheelchair.
Oh, wow. Do you want to show us that?
Absolutely.
Okay.
He sits on a wheelchair with a Surface tablet.
So in this research prototype, we use an eye tracker connected to a Surface device.
Got it. So basically now you're just gazing where you want to go. And so this app is just basically a Surface with this app is what's moving the wheelchair.
That's correct. Yep. I just look where I want to go and it sees where my
eye. And so how do you go back? Oh, yeah, I see it.
You're just look down.
A down arrow lights up.
So it's basically just like a virtual joystick.
Yeah. That's very, very cool. So this is, a developer can just write this using the eye control APIs.
Absolutely, yeah. It's very straightforward.
And this remote controlled car, same thing?
We worked with Team Gleason in order to create an eye controlled RC car. And the basic idea is just how do you have fun with your loved ones, even though you can only use your eyes to control your world around you. We also worked with an individual who was a former musician, and we made it so he could control a drum kit with his eyes. I think we're only just tapping the potential for what can be done. Obviously, accessibility is a good entry point, but I think there's a lot of universal applications as well.
That's right. I mean, that's kind of one of the things that I think developers can really start thinking about, which is the universal design and these capabilities not only, in fact, bring more people to participate in our society and our economy,
right,
but it also can enhance the experiences for everyone. So where do people go to get started?
Yeah, so for more information on Eye Control for Windows, as well as the Eye Control APIs, you can go to aka.ms/EyeControlAPI.
Thank you so much, Jon.
Thank you.
It's such a pleasure.
They shake hands and smile. Microsoft.